In the past two lessons, we learned the basics of navigation and landing under ideal conditions. In this lesson, we put what you learned to the test by finding an airfield and landing area at night during a thunderstorm. Sounds good, right? Let's turn on the clock here and press the button. We're currently in route mode. We have no airfield at the final route destination, so let's select return mode by pressing 1. Using what you learned about course steering through the HUD and ADI, fly the assigned return course that will lead you to the ILS intercept for Beslan Airfield. As you start to descend, you'll probably pick up a lot of speed. Don't forget that you can deploy the air brakes by pressing B. As we get closer to the airfield, I should also mention that not all airfields have Russian ILS, as we had in the last lesson. Airfields that do include Mazdar, Kursk, Maikov, and Krasnodar Center. Being that Beslan does not have this, you will not have the HUD ILS indications. However, if you look down at your HSI, you'll notice a dashed cross in the center and both solid vertical and horizontal lines. The dashed lines are fixed and represent the optimal glide slope and localizer positions with the solid lines. Press the spacebar to continue. If the glide slope bar is below the dashed line, you are above glide slope. If it is above the dashed line, you are under glide slope. If the localizer line is left of center, you need to fly to the left. If the localizer is to the right of center, you need to fly to the right. You always fly to the needle.
102, станок. Проверьте выпуск шасси. Ветер у земли 167, скорость 9 метров в секунду. Посадочный 10.
As you pass over the inner marker beacon, you may have noticed a little bit of crosswind from south to north. To counter this, input a little left rudder by pressing Z and add a little right bank to keep your nose tracking down the runway. Looks like you got her down in one piece. You can end the lesson now.
1-0-2. Заруливайте на стоянку.